My name is Matthew Yates, and today I'm going to walk you through a few aspects of the Puppet Enterprise Web UI, otherwise known as the console. The version I'll be showing you is Puppet Enterprise 2019. To get started, you will log in using the administrative password set during the installation. But soon after logging in, you'll need to configure your users and their respective permissions, or leverage our existing LDAP integration. When you log in, you're always presented with this heads-up display of your full environment under management, and you can easily see what nodes are running and forcing, no op, or no longer reporting in. And you can apply a filter if you'd like, based on facts, to limit the number of systems that you see here. Below this overview, you can find the last run report status of all your nodes. Here you can see their status, a link to the last run report, as well as a link to the node name itself, which will reveal additional details to you. On the top right hand corner, you'll see two links, one for Puppet Services status, which shows you the underlying Puppet Enterprise services and their statuses, as well as a link to Radiator, which opens up a separate tab to show you a simplified view of the last run of all your Puppet nodes. On the left-hand navigation side, we've got several different headers for the different areas in which you'll interact with Puppet Enterprise. Under Inspect, we can click on Nodes, and you'll see the node name, and you can click there and find additional information on the node, as well as a link to the last run report. Under the Packages link, we have Package Inspector, which, if you enable this feature, will collect information about all the packages installed on your systems. And that includes all the packages, even if they are not currently being managed by any Puppet code. The Reports link takes you to all your previously run reports that correspond to your Puppet runs, allows you to quickly and easily see historical run information. The Jobs link is a shortcut to show you any previously run jobs, which would execute a Puppet run or a task or a plan or a scheduled task. The Events link takes you through to see the Event Inspector, which allows you to gain further introspection on the last Puppet runs. And under the Configuration header, we have Classification, which is where you group systems and can define the policies by which you can set which nodes should get particular bits of your Puppet code. Under Run, we have Puppet, which allows you to instruct Puppet nodes to check in, and this will give you somewhat of a push type functionality for instructing the nodes to check in. Under Tasks, this allows you to run ad hoc tasks against your nodes, whether they're existing nodes with agents on them, or as well additionally to nodes that are potentially agentless. Under Setup, we have a section called Unsigned Certs, and this gives you information about how to install the agent, as well as ability to do it agentlessly and direct that, as well as this would be the page where if you had any unsigned certs, they will show up here and you can authorize, and once you sign that cert, the agent can then communicate with the master. The access control link is where we have all the settings for your role-based access controls, as well as configuring the external directory. The license link gives you information about your current license, as well as a link for information on how to purge any existing nodes, as well as how to contact sales. There's a little area beneath setup which has a few items as well. My account is a link that will show you your current metadata for your user account and any activity associated with that account. We also have Help, which is a link to this page, which links out to the product documentation. And finally, we have Logout, which allows you to end your user session. And on the very bottom left-hand corner, we prominently display the current version that you're running. And if you click this, it's actually a link to our download page, which you can use to help you when you prepare for your next upgrade. Thank you for your time and enjoy using Puppet Enterprise.